Scream it out now! Oh, yeah.
You bet. I made this wrong pitch too.
What's up, Direct Edition attendees? It's your boy, the Robot Barbecue! T-Wama will bring you another fresh, healthy, keeping hot plate of the Direct Edition where you get the latest news and opinion on comic books, video games, related movies, action figures, and what are we going to go with?
A Tinkerbell booty shake.
A Tinkerbell booty shake of anime. Tinkerbell booty shake.
Booty shake.
Well,
that's a tiny booty shake.
Hey, how big is our anime?
A Tinkerbell booty shake.
There you have it. There you have it.
Of course, we got the Forever Squad in the building. What's up, fellas?
What's up? Oh,
it's going down.
Is it going down?
On a Friday?
Well, it should. It needs to.
Well, it's coming up on my Friday.
We got the Gummy Bear Assassin in the building.
No. I got a new one.
Oh yeah.
Hey. Salubrious salutations. It's the Teddy Graham Nightmare coming to you live from Jabba's Secret Palace.
From Jabba's Secret Palace?
That's right, Jabba's Secret Palace. We ain't got no rancor in the air, though. Oh.
Who knew Jabba had a secret palace?
Apparently him. He is the only one.
You the only one at the secret palace?
Oh, well, you in the palace.
Oh. And on that note.
You know, you know he's dead, right?
Oh, okay. Good. Long as Jabba dead.
She did choke him out with that chain.
Can you imagine Jabba walking in there by the party? And they just stop.
He slide in on his sled.
He
ain't got enough rancors for that.
What had happened was...
Damn, we thought you weren't coming back.
Somebody said you got choked by a chain?
And of course we got the Dynamite Deity of Dissolution in the house. Do work, Dark Man.
What's happening, y'all? You know, your boy is happy that it's Friday. I don't really get excited until it's the showtime. Because up until then, I still have to work.
Don't we all?
Hey, I just walked out. Hey.
All of us be on that breadwinner.
Man. Then, this morning, I already had two alarms set.
Why do you have two alarms set?
If the first one wake me up, you know, the second one is just a party then, cause you know, I'm jamming then, cause I got a song that come on, so it's like, yeah.
I feel you. You know, I got two alarms too.
It make you feel good. Well, I turned both of them off.
See, I got a third.
It kind of defeats the purpose.
It does. But you know, the Oracle was there, and she was like, hey, it's, 7:30.
Get your ass up.
So.
AKA. If you don't get your ass up.
So then, I'm like, yeah, you know, I had a dream, told her about my dream. It wasn't Martin Luther King dream, but it was mine's own.
Then by the end, it was 8 o'clock.
So, I did that, fell back to sleep. She said, hey, it's 8 o'clock. I'm like, oh, smart.
Now you really late.
Now I'm late for real. Man, I knew it was going to be a long day after that.
Yeah.
I was sleeping like it sat there. It wasn't.
So Agent 33 and Demon Queen of Hype is on the way. So, but we're going ahead and kick off some things.
Yes, because they aren't really in favor of this.
Usually we go ahead and jump into some nerdgasm.
Yes, we do.
We have some.
I have one.
I think we have a collective one, but go ahead.
Oh, y'all go first.
No, you first.
Oh, me first?
Yes, sir.
Well, my nerdgasm has nothing to do with comic books, anime, art. Well,
that makes it even better.
There is an art. Boy, I'm straight out of Compton. I'm ready, boy.
Can't wait.
Man, so tomorrow morning, I'm going to check it out.
Tomorrow morning? You going to wait for Sunday Funday?
No, because Sunday Funday is the TDE day. We figure out, you know, what movie we want to check out. But straight out of Compton?
So what you're saying is, you got to go see it by yourself first.
No, I'm not. No. I talked
like.
To Dirty CG's this morning. He was like, I'm down.
Son of a bitch. I mean, I ain't even get it out.
That's good. Oh.
That's allowed.
The female careful.
Bitch is allowed.
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't get
remember,
it all
you
out.
Don't remember that whole escapade?
Yeah.
Bitch.
So, you know, I'm putting them black boots on. Get my Levi's. With my black Raider shirt, NWA hat, and I'm coming straight out of Compton.
I've seen a lot of the straight out of whatever.
Yeah.
Post that was going up. Okay, hold on, let me figure out how to
turn this. Turn that volume down.
I know, I got that same problem sometimes.
You would think I would know by now.
Yeah, I know, right? Because I usually do it.
What I'm going to do, I'm just going to go ahead and pause it.
Not even going to lower the volume. You're just going to pause.
That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and pause it. But I've seen a lot of the straight out of whatever coming out. And after a while, it started to drive me crazy.
I know.
People were getting ridiculous with it.
One or two was fun. Then everybody doing a damn thing. It gets annoying real quick.
Straight out of everything.
Hey. Just do like me and put everybody post on your Facebook page at the bottom.
No, you did it cool because you did it first. So you were good. Yeah. You did it first. You were good. The third or fourth person who did it, they were straight out ridiculous, okay?
Yeah, I was making mine personal. I was sending people theirs in a text.
Hey, you did it right. It was all right.
Look, Miss Money, when you sent the one for Miss Money Penny and she made her Facebook profile, I went to work and my boss asked me, she was like, how she did that? We've been trying to do that all weekend.
Hey, you should have looked at him then and said, you know what? I can tell you don't follow the directed dish.
I should have. And I was like, you know what? I'm getting tired of seeing those. And she was like, we've been trying to do ours all weekend, but we can't get it to work. It won't download to our Facebook page.
So they doing that instead of doing work?
Well, she was trying to, that was when we got back Monday.
Right. Nice.
So.
Okay, to the people out there listening, just a little key bit of information. There's no point in clicking the download from your phone. Just stop it. Do a screenshot, edit, crop that thing.
That's sitting on the way.
There you have it. You can do whatever you want with it after.
Boom, bam, pow, ping, pong, chow.
Don't call your boy do work for something, for no reason.
Right?
I'm going to figure it out.
Jewish right. Nerdgasm?
Yes, I got a nerdgasm. Myself, Dewart, and Mobile here, although we didn't go together, we kind of went in separate days, but we did go and get a chance to watch the special screening of Dragon Ball Z Resurrection.
There was only one common denominator in that equation.
Yeah, Matt Jushin.
Yes.
Your boy had to see it twice. It was so good, I had to go back for a second round.
And hey, he didn't even invite me.
That might be me from Naruto, I gotta say. I'm letting you know now. It might be me from Naruto. Just FYI. But I'll be damned if I pay another $25 for two people. Movie prices are ridiculous.
Boy, they got
nowadays.
Him. Ticket $12.50 day for adult kid and adult little person.
$12.50.
Across the board.
Man, you should have gave him that look, that do work look.
And then she got the nerve to ask me, she was like, well, we also have a program where you can purchase movie tickets for $5 before 6. Program? You mean I gotta sign up for this? Would you like to sign up? Hell no! Give my tickets.
Movie done started. We had time with you.
Look, if Milo would have said that he was hungry, I'd say, here, here's, chew on this. Chew on this ticket stuff. That's why I was for the 10 worth of food right there.
Man, hey, your boy do work starting a new campaign. I told Jushin when we went and saw Dragon Ball Z. I'm starting to walk into the movie theater with whatever I want to see when they gonna say something.
I want to be there.
Say nothing to them last time.
Not one time?
Man, yeah. I walked in, I had a bag from GameStop. I wasn't hiding it, wasn't trying to hide it. It had Jushin's, what is it, R2B1?
B1, yeah.
It had that in it, his little Funko Pop.
Little Funko Pop Astro Mech Droid. Appreciate it.
R2-D1. Yeah.
Just a little R2-D2 Astro Mech and Funko Pop form.
Why R2-D1?
Because he, I don't know. Hey, man offered it to me. I accepted it. Okay, so Star Wars, get that.
I thought it was...
Man offers you an Astro Mech Droid. You don't turn him down.
I'm turning down an Astro Mech
You don't turn down an Astro Mech Droid. Hey, look. R2 would save everybody's ass in Star Wars.
No, R2-D2 has saved everybody's ass. I don't know what R2-D1 is doing.
You gotta give him a chance.
He must be changing the oil on the X-Wing or something. I don't know where he at.
Hey, man, that X-Wing still flies.
I think I'm walking in with a backpack, probably a pillow.
Bring a blanket.
I'm going to bring a sleeping bag. I just want somebody to say something. I don't want to bring it in. I just want to see how far you're going to let me go.
I think he'll actually get to the theater before somebody says that.
And that's it. That's all they're going to say.
I mean, there was one time I was walking in. I had my ticket, but I was, you know, tweeting something or whatever. So I'm walking past the ticket taker. He didn't say anything. He, like, stopped.
Thought about it.
And then I was like 3 feet away from them. Oh, my bad. When you going to say something?
No, because he look. It's like a computer. You look at do what walk and you register. Like, compute ass whooping in evidence. So leave that alone.
Can you look? Take that ass whooping?
I'm not the biggest guy. I'm not the meanest guy.
Are you looking to take a nap right now?
Hey. I paid my money just like the next person, man. You can say something. This your job. Say something.
Say it with your chest.
But would I be in trouble for... Just say something. Would I be in trouble for saying that?
Yeah.
Come on, man.
I think you can walk into the White House in your drawers. No one would do a damn thing.
Well, I got to be in
trouble. Just saying. Because
he don't like to wear pants.
I don't.
I'm not menacing. I don't understand.
You were walking the White House. Walking into the Oval Office, get some coffee. You know what I'm saying? Hey, Mr. President.
The president having a meeting and everybody.
He'd be up there in his drawers and be like,
ladies and gentlemen, I'll be cabinet the president. This is February Darkman.
Be like, I'll be finishing the minute.
Obama just let him go.
So y'all wrong.
Make sure that man got as much sugar.
Right, they switch to decaf. Tell nobody nothing.
Hey, Secret Service doing bad already. They can't stop nothing. They stand outside the White House with a stop sign. People run right through it.
Hey, that couldn't have happened back in the 80s. You couldn't have ran through that.
Man.
Back in the 80s, they shot first, asked questions later.
Nowadays,
that's when they interrogated you after they shot you.
Yeah, now they give you a pillow and ask you soft questions.
Like, oh, you know, you shot me in the ass. Pow! I shot the other one.
Now you can't sit down.
You gonna talk? So, Jushin, that was your nergasm?
That was. That was one of them. I can't think of the second one right now.
Fantastic Four.
No, that was not a nerdgasm. Oh, that was a nerd-compoop.
It was such a nerdgasm.
That was a nerd-compoop.
And if you want to look at Jushin's article, he wrote a review on Dragon Ball Z, F, yep. Resurrection F, and Fantastic Four.
I guess Fantastic Four was real short.
It's short.
No, it wasn't short.
Damn near non-existent.
No, you're talking about the article.
Oh, I'm talking about the movie.
Wait a minute. You had more to say about the article than the movie itself?
Dude, yes.
Yeah, he wrote an article. Fantastic Four was a fantastic flop.
That it was.
And they go with a sequel.
I don't know.
We'll talk about it later.
Yeah, they put the FYC on it. And say we'll talk about it later.
Speaking of talking about it later.
What's up?
How about you think, what do you think of doing a movie Monday for Twitch, right? Where, because we go on Sundays.
Yes.
And, well, I mean, it might take away from the show a bit. But, like, 30 minutes where we discuss whatever movie it is we saw or...
I don't see nothing wrong with that. Movie Monday. Because I also have some other ideas for the beef up our Twitch stream, but we'll get on that.
Yes, we did.
We'll get on that in a minute.
All right.
When the cameras are off. Eavesdropping on.
We need more listeners so that way we can get paid, because this gas money ain't helping me.
Man, you ain't bought gas in 6 years. You got the Shogun at the house. She got an oil rig over there in Dubai and all that, man.
Look, just because she diversified her bonds, I mean.
We feel the gas prices.
Hey, I feel the gas.
You don't feel no gas prices.
Oil. Ain't nobody saying nothing about no oil.
I know. Run! All right. What about your nergasm?
My nergasm was DC is doing a graphic novel movie release. They're like all of their animated movies, they're pairing them with the graphic novels that they were based off of. And they're like re-releasing it like on Blu-ray. I thought that was pretty sweet. It wasn't like overblown nergasm or anything like that, but I thought that was pretty sweet.
You only come to the table with one?
Yeah.
It's the first and the longest.
I've been doing work this week.
Hey, that's what you're talking about. Don't do work.
I've been on the grind. I've been on the grind.
Thank you. Because we don't swing like that. We'll be around here doing work.
Playing cake. Yeah, it's a long thing.
You can't make your pancakes.
But they are not going to get that reference.
Just saying, we get it, and that's enough.
Now, however, I do get two nerds and people.
Uh-oh. Is one of them Fantastic Four?
No. That's not my nerd. The first one was, I saw the new trailer to Jim and the Hologram.
Oh, Jesus
Christ. Where they introduced Synergy.
The first time, it was horrible. You actually went back and watched the second one?
Well, they introduced Synergy.
It didn't matter. It ain't gonna help.
So they were saying that it was gonna be more like the TV series than the original trailer was. So they introduced Synergy, which was...
Did they rewrite the whole movie?
Pretty much. Synergy is like a...
Evil version of the movie?
No. It's like a robot.
What?
That... Like, pretty much like the Wally robot?
Yeah.
The one, the white one, Eve?
Mm-hmm.
Synergy is pretty much like that. So... Congratulations, Jim and the Holograms. You get the nerd compute because that was outrageously stupid. Somebody, and I put an article up on the site about this, about the movie. Yeah, apparently, whoever is directing this movie is somebody who doesn't appreciate the source material because they're just doing what they want with it. And I see that a lot with intellectual property, especially coming out of Japan.
Yeah.
They don't appreciate the source material, so they just...
They just make up.
They just say Smurf at all.
What is it, live action?
Which one?
The Naruto.
Yes.
They doing the same thing they did with Dragon Ball. Just gonna create something that's garbage.
Say that.
That's all that ever happens when we get a hold of something from Japan.
See, how can you say that though? But you excited about the Ghost in the Shell. The live action Ghost in the Shell.
Yeah, I'm holding that hope, but I know where to put that. Smurf it up.
Yeah, because we've smurfed up every Japanese anime that we brought over has been smurfed up. You can't name one.
North Star? Garbage.
Why don't they just... Okay. We want to do this.
Look, we did Godzilla twice.
Oh, man, that's horrible.
Exactly. Exactly. The first time it was what? And then the second time it was a dog?
The last Godzilla movie, my boy Nightwing, 904, he purchased it. Not only...
Nightwing 904, a.k.a. Arnold.
Yes. Not only did he purchase it in Blu-ray, but he also purchased it in 3D.
So that set him back like $5.99.
He let me borrow it because I wasn't going to pay for it. I wasn't going to watch it, but he was like, hey, check this out. Let me know how you feel. I said, I brought it back to him. I said, that movie, you shouldn't have purchased it. Two, it shouldn't have been
made
in 3D.
Oh, hell no.
Because 98% of the movie is dark. How do you see something coming at you in the dark? He's like, but you can see the flame. Yeah, oh, at the end, you can see the flame. And I said, what happened to the foot of Godzilla? He had a leg with nubs at the end.
That's why I think he was like, and his snout was short. That's why I thought he looked like a dog. I'm like, is he standing on stumps? I mean, how is he getting around?
That's because you're used to the classic Godzilla.
I am used to the classic Godzilla.
If it's not broke, why
fix it? Why go out there and decide to design something new?
You can make it look just like the old one. Show the people, not us.
Oh, yeah,
we already see it.
They can see it.
All right, that's enough.
I'm just making sure everyone saw enough.
All you have to do is take what's already out there and bring it to this time. You don't have to change much with the characters. Just bring it up.
You can't do that.
Apparently, they feel like what's been working for centuries, years, is not going to translate well to the fans who are going to go see it, who've already seen what's been working for centuries and years.
Here's my thing. If you don't understand the source material, you don't know what has come before, that's what Amazon is for. Go find the movies from before and watch them.
Retail.
And look, I went and got a whole collection of guys in the movies now.
There's a thing called the internet. Reach out and talk to the person that did it.
Seriously.
Bring them over.
Send an email. I mean.
That's like them trying to, let's remake the Hoover Dam, but we're going to use Chick-fil-A waffle fries.
That damn ain't gonna last long. I can tell you that right now. Waffle fries good in the mud. If you know somebody gonna walk by and be like, and that's all it takes. That's all it takes. One fry out of place.
You know what? This dam isn't working. We're gonna build a new one.
Out of waffle fries.
This dam is hell that water. How long since it's been constructed? And now you want to create something? Come on now.
It's gonna be better. We'll make it bigger.
Out of waffle fry.
We have all the supply we need
California
until Sunday.
California don't get enough water. It is. You want to take out the rest of the water? You don't want the rest of the water on the western side of that country? Come on now.
So, that's so crazy. From the rest of that country.
Western side of the country. Shut. I said it. Limit.
Sorry.
You heard it first here.
Yeah, we know. Because we go to Texas. If he heard it.
California from the rest of the country. So that was my first miracle poop about the Jim and the Hologram trailer. Second trailer I saw. My second miracle poop is this judge. I'm kind of on the fence on who I should give it to.
Oh, boy.
Because this judge, I don't know if it's either the judge or the psychologist.
Probably both.
The sentencing judge was Paul Muscat. Muscat. Muscat.
What was the offense?
The offense was this 52-year-old man pled guilty to possessing child pornography after police raided his home in April 2012.
Jared?
Now... He only had 44 images.
Jared from Subway?
Of actual children. The other 361 images were of anime. So,
you know what?
The psychologist says that anime leads to child pornography.
What? Look, and I'm going to tell you something.
You got a PhD in pornography.
Let me tell you something, because half of that stuff...
Well, yeah, anime leads to child pornography. Not pornography. Child pornography.
Because half of that stuff is... It's about underage kids, high school kids. They don't make no... trying to hide it. Sometimes they try, in the wording, they'll try to put asterisks in where they put high school or middle school or something like that, so that way you don't really know the age or attenuate the age, but you know what it is. So you have to, like, I'm like, I don't know, like, you have to tread carefully when you're looking at that stuff.
It's a fine line.
Yeah, it's a very fine line, because I don't look at half that stuff, because it either deals with females, uchinari, females with dicks, or kids. And at that point, you just gotta leave it alone, because if someone decides to look at your hard drive, they could technically classify that as porn. It's child pornography.
It's been done before. When there was another case that the Common Book Legal Defense Fund got involved with, there was a guy who had some anime on his computer, and he was trying to go to Canada Expo, and they shot him at the border and arrested him.
I heard it's hard to get in Canada. But
that's why I always say, if we go to Canada Expo, we can't take Massachusetts.
I'm just not going to take anything.
He can't.
I can't take no hard drives.
See, I just don't believe it. I don't believe you're not. You're just not going to take it.
You're like, ah! What is this?
What are they going to search my? Am I? They're going to take my hard drive and look through it? Canadians might.
That's my thumb drive. What's on this? Pictures of food.
So was it a random check? As far as the Canadian, you don't know.
I don't see how he got caught. But he was charged with aggravated offense and possessing child pornography relating to the images of actual children, as well as non-aggravated charge in relation to the anime images. So the anime images were non-aggravated, and the child pornography was aggravated, which it should be. And he made the argument that because they were cartoon images, they weren't really hurting. Yeah, they weren't real children. They weren't hurting anyone.
Okay. Damn that. What about these real kids?
I know, right?
I don't really care about anime.
You got real. Yeah, let's.
But my point was, is that how the psychologist was saying that because he started off with the anime,
it led him.
Is that what he says?
That's what the psychologist was saying. And the judge agreed with. That's why I was having, hard time of deciding who the miracle to go to.
I would say because it goes to the psychiatrist.
I can't say it's on. I'd say it's on the person who had the damn child pornography to begin with.
It's not the anime.
Yeah, I don't think it's the anime.
That's what I'm saying.
But first off, how do they know which came first, the chicken or the egg? Was the child pornography on there first, and then somebody was like, "Hey, you know." You might want to go to this anime route because these aren't real kids, but they're in the forms of. All of it's creepy. And he need his ass whooped or something, because... Okay, nerd, whatever.
And Lizzie has a point. The anime is rated. Just like,
and even Japanese, even their anime, they it's against their law to show the sexual organs clearly. So they have like
that's in anything.
So they have like bars or something to distort their images, or they have it blurred out or whatever. So,
but they're not as censored as we are.
Not even, I don't know. We're still talking about people who sell youth candies out of India. At a vending machine.
There's a formula to that. I found that out.
Excuse me?
There's a formula to that. It's like like hot sauce mixed with tuna, and it's a formula.
So these aren't real panties worn by
somebody. They're real panties.
No, I'm saying they're not worn by somebody.
Yeah, they're not really worn.
So you go to a vending machine and you buy these.
Put a quarter in and you get the draws. And then.
Because apparently hot sauce and tuna makes you smell like a girl's dad. I don't know. It doesn't sound right to me either, because,
Aren't there a lot of people in Japan?
There are a lot. A lot of perverted people in Japan.
Why don't you just go get your real chick with real panties?
And smell her drawers?
I'm saying, if that's your thing, I'm not trying to knock the man who created the vending machine, but if you're going to buy these at the vending machine,
I wonder how much they cost.
Where is your happy ending? Because I'd rather have
the real thing,
the woman, than the panties.
I agree with you there. 110% work. But when she gone.
When she gone, she coming back.
Unless.
But until she get back.
Hey, whatever. I can wait.
Well, hold on. Wicked Saint Jared didn't have.
Oh, the fans right, did go to Jared's house.
So how did they find out? I read that they found out about Jared because he was texting manager or a supervisor, somebody from Subway, about meeting her underage sister, and she got uncomfortable, and she turned him over. Said that she dimed on him, saying that he shouldn't be around children, and she doesn't want any of his product or promotion in her store.
You lose weight, you become the image of Subway, and then you fall by your vice, child pornography.
I'm sure it's not the first time.
Oh no! Here's the thing. This is what I've realized.
He just hide it well.
People who have money and power have the wildest vices. Like me and you may have some normal thing, you know.
Well, wait, bitch. The me and you thing. There is no me and you vice.
Let me take that back. The regular income people may have a normal thing. Like some people got drugs, you know. Some people
always say there are different levels of perversion.
There are different levels.
While you and I work, maybe down here.
Massachusetts.
I said he had a PhD.
Maybe up here. However, there's still some people.
Because they can afford it, and it goes skyrocket. And I think we.
So, Jushin, if you could afford it.
No, you don't. Don't ask. I was going to snatch all the mics.
The answer is yes. The answer is yes. I don't care what it is.
Snatch all the.
The big old Dave in?
I thought the door was. It's not locked.
Does he know that?
Yeah.
You know he's Caucasian, right? He'll wait at the door until somebody comes over.
He's not standing there.
Come on now, he's probably got a drink smoking.
I'll be right back. I'll be right back.
What does Caucasian have to do with it? He could. Why you just couldn't say he's law abiding?
Because there's a difference. There is a difference. Come on now. You go to a Caucasian neighborhood where they live at, everyone's got their garage doors open, kids from down the street
it's
coming
door,
around your house.
Garage door.
I said.
You said those.
So whatever. You come in this neighborhood.
What's wrong with this neighborhood?
Hey, let me ask you something. How many of your neighbors do you know first name?
One?
Come on now. How many of your neighbors do you know?
See?
No. Because
it's that stereotype.
I've met all his neighbors at least one time. Mobile, how many of your neighbors do you know on a first name basis?
One? Actually,
ask me.
I know.
None.
Exactly, because you ain't.
Actually,
you are a little antisocial.
What? You live in that dark backwoods road.
Actually,
how do I live on
any of them on the first name. I just know them by face.
No, that doesn't count. That means you have to actually have.
You have to have interaction. You have to have face to face.
How many have you had interaction with your neighbors?
I do have interaction with my neighbors because when we first moved in.
Not calling the cops.
I haven't called the cops on this.
Now, do you know them on a first name basis?
When we first moved in, he brought the keys over and he was like, I had an extra set of keys. And I was like, thanks, you changed the locks anyway.
Have you talked to him since?
But appreciate it. Yeah, every time I see him and we meet at the same time. Hey,
what's
how you doing? Like I said, every time I see him, we leave
hey, what's up? His name's Mr. Neighbor, bitch. What do you mean? Hey, Mr. Neighbor.
That's not his name. You know it.
How many of your neighbors do you know?
I know. Well, she moved out.
Oh, I see, it had to be a she, though.
An older lady.
What? That doesn't matter.
She moved out. The next door lady, I know her.
What they call them, right?
I know all my neighbors, because we live in an apartment, so I know that one, the one down below me, because he always apologizes for playing music too loud.
We're not calling them cougars no more, we call them Chitara.
Chitara's mouth.
She's not a Chitara.
That's where we're going to go.
She's not a Chitara.
She's not a Chitara?
No, she's not.
Well,
although the next door neighbor is a Chitara.
Can you explain this to me?
Okay.
Since you know, since you're well-versed in Jushin.
I am. I'm the resident Jushin translator.
How is it?
Does really anybody know Jushin?
I live on the corner of my street, and he tells me that I live in the backwoods.
Because you got more trees than he do.
He's in an apartment.
Exactly.
I've got one tree, and it's right out in front of that.
Now, that does make sense. In the big scheme of things, that does make sense.
Stop it.
Okay.
And just joining us, we got the sultry Sith of Solo Silkiness.
Solo Silkiness.
Wicked has asked us if we're going to talk about comics today.
If he wants to talk about comics, why don't he come over here and talk about comics himself? We having a frat. Wait, is he here?
Hey, that was quick.
Did you say his name three times? You show up?
Bad Wicked. Yeah, we just stand in front of a mirror, right?
But Jessica and Agent 33, so we were talking about some the nerd complaints that we gave out. First one was the Gemini Holograms trailer where they introduced Synergy.
Oof.
Yeah.
Mm. That's a nerd complaint in and of itself, isn't it?
And the second one was that this I couldn't find out where he was at, but this guy he was sent to how many counts did he have?
One was more than enough, to tell you the truth.
Yeah, he aggravated offense and possessing child pornography. But 90% of what he had was anime. And the judge and the psychologist were saying that the anime leads to child pornography.
That's their clinical.
That was their
so they're clinical. Basically saying that because I like anime, eventually I'm going to look at child pornography.
Pretty much what they diagnosed.
Hey, don't bring your laptop in my house.
You might have folders mixed up. Ain't nobody trying to see all that. All right?
As a matter of fact, I think I need to take those Dragon Ball Z's off my hard drive.
You sure they all Dragon Ball Z?
I can't find them.
I like to see what they title. So, before Wicked knock on the door, for real.
Well, and just, I'm very surprised that, you know, the whole nerd kapoof for this week is the dismal showing, I'm sure we'll get to this later, of the Fantastic Four at the box office.
Not yet.
Hey, we didn't mention that, but we said we'll cover that in movie.
Yeah, we didn't cover
it's
that.
Gonna make more than Jim and the Holograms.
Wait, what? I really don't know about all that now. That's going out on the limb.
Oh no, I think Jimmy.
You must be playing in Vegas odds.
Jimmy and the Holograms made top 10.
Top 10 where?
$10.
So, jumping in the comics. Apparently Deadpool.
I ain't scared of Wicked.
Look man, we're doing this for Lizzie, not Wicked, okay? Wicked do realize that it is do work talking noise, not
now you snitching? There's a camera.
I'll hey, look. You ass under the bus. And
I don't know about you, but I've had one of those rear chokes more than once. Okay,
and you deserve each and every one of them. I'm
oh,
sure.
I did. Possibly.
Jose put his baguettes on your neck.
Hey, we're not talking about that right now. We're not talking about that right now. As you were saying, sir.
His baguettes.
You know what? You keep it up. I'm gonna rub my kiwis on that smooth dome.
Before you leave it, even more perverted.
See,
in
see, you gotta take the anime off. Apparently, you gotta take the anime off.
Before it gets even more out of control over here, we rub the kiwis back. There's a new Deadpool and Cable series coming out, and probably to build more hype for Deadpool movie. Because he already has, what, one, two, I think he has two series already, comic books.
He's becoming the go-to-the-well type guy.
I think he is.
Been like that for a little while now.
Because ever since they started killing off Wolverine, they started putting him more and more.
Thank goodness. But the Monday mashup.
Yeah.
When we put the Monday mashup, my prediction was that Deadpool's going to take the cake next year. He's going to set the bar. Because you got X-Men Apocalypse is the third film. Captain America 3 is the third film. And I thought there was one more.
A third film?
That comes out next
week. X-Men.
No, I said Thor Ragnarok, but that's not Thor.
That's 17. Yeah.
Right. But those two third films, and let's be honest, all comic book movies third films have been crap.
Yeah. Wait.
Name one.
I think Blade was alright.
Man, welcome to the comedy hour here at the Director Dish.
We can come get you for it.
We can cover your ears. You a damn liar.
He definitely said Blade was all right. Blade was all right.
Like I said, we can cover your ears. You a goddamn liar.
He almost got it out with a straight face.
So it's like a curse of threes with comic book books.
Blade was all right.
Blade 3.
Well, you're not listening
to Iron Man 3.
That was alright.
Just because it triumphed at the box office doesn't mean the story was good.
X-Men 3, The Last Stand.
Ooh, that was not good.
That went downhill as soon as they killed Cyclops.
So all those threes, and then now with Cap 3 coming up, and X-Men Apocalypse, which would be the third film.
Yep.
My only problem with Cap and Apocalypse is it's the same month.
Okay.
That's why I initially said on mine that I thought Cap would take it, but it depend on when they release. So if they release Cap earlier in the month and they release Wolverine later in the month, I think Cap would outdo Deadpool.
No.
I don't think he'd outdo Deadpool, but I definitely think he's going to outdo Apocalypse for sure.
I think he's going to outdo Deadpool.
I don't think he's gonna outdo that.
Because I don't think, I think the women are going to, lean more towards Cap than Deadpool.
Here's the thing. It's gonna be on the family. And that's why I think Cap's gonna, rival Deadpool. It's gonna take over Deadpool because you can take a kid to go to Captain America because he is the American symbol, you know? Kids love him, women love him, men love him. And then you go see Deadpool,
certain men.
But you need to
like it. Deadpool, all right.
But Deadpool's going to be graphic, and people may not want to take the kids.
It's rated R.
It is rated R. Some people may not take the kids.
But then again, so is Blade. And Blade did very well. The first Blade did
very well.
If
Blade 3 was all right.
We said the first Blade, son.
Oh! You got your mic turned down, son! Damn!
I got your back, Wiggy.
He telling y'all gonna leave Blade alone.
See? I'm just trying to get back after that. I ain't scared of Wicked. Y'all quit putting salt.
He gonna keep talking.
So all of these first movies, you know, Deadpool, Doctor Strange, I think those are gonna be the ones that kick off without a hitch.
That's my sleeper, Doctor Strange.
I think Doctor Strange is gonna be a real good one.
Because I like the actor from Sherlock.
Yeah.
It depends on their marketing.
I don't know about Sherlock, but he played a hell of a con in Star Trek.
Yeah.
You should watch, now that you have Netflix password and everything.
I got my own account and everything, you know.
You should watch that Sherlock.
I only had to pay $12 for it, but I do have my own account now.
Now that you got your own Netflix password, I got my own account.
It's got a password, doesn't it?
I stood up like I knew what I was doing.
Big boy now.
Yeah. Grown folk up in here.
The only one that's not going to make it, I don't think, is Suicide Squad.
I think that's going to surprise people.
That's what I think.
I still don't
know.
As long as they stop with these more scenes from Suicide Squad, if they just let that go.
But think about what they've done with Deadpool. Every second, third post you see on Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, it's a Deadpool. New shot.
here's my thing. You can't oversaturate the market. I think, because they did it with Ant-Man a little bit. They pushed too much marketing for Ant-Man.
They did.
Ant-Man was good, but too much marketing for Ant-Man.
It was what?
It was good. Yeah, that's right. I said it. It was good.
Who the hell is that?
He's going to be the same cat that shows up for Jessica Jones.
He had to eat it twice. Okay, because he said Ant-Man wasn't going to be about nothing, and he said Fantastic Four was going to be the ball.
Yeah, I've had to eat twice, though.
That makes room for Jessica Jones, no, baby. Yes, it does.
That's not.
Look, apparently he likes eating his work.
I'm not the one who's testing, so there's going to be nothing to eat.
Throw some hot sauce on.
Can you give him some hot sauce, some cider mustard, and some sauerkraut?
don't eat none of that.
And our next thing was, as I said earlier, which was my nerdgasm, the graphic novels and animated films that DC is putting together. Because DC's animated films has always been on pause. But now they're going to pair them with the source material that they're based off of and the graphic novel and release the whole thing. So, and I think that's a pretty badass idea.
Why didn't somebody think of it sooner?
Exactly. And I had a list of the ones that they're releasing. It was like, but Batman, Black and White, and the Crisis on Two Earths for the DC Blu-rays.
Movies?
Yeah.
That's usually what a Blu-ray is.
But I think in the week for this week, while Jushin's looking up the Blu-rays, it was Bombshells number one.
Oh, I didn't make it to the shops this week.
I got it in there.
Any shop.
Didn't make it out there.
So, alright, now listen to this. This is my next one. Apparently, Stan Lee's ex-assistant has filed a lawsuit against Mr. Stan Lee.
Of course. He's getting ready to die, and we're going to sue.
Apparently, Stan made him work a little bit.
The verbal abuse?
Because he's garbage.
Stan Lee told him he wasn't about...
He wasn't about Smurf?
Stan Lee told him he wasn't about Smurf. Stanley's daughter told him he wasn't about Smurf.
Okay, where the problem at? Because I ain't heard the problem come up yet.
He said it was verbal abuse, and then he was wrongfully fired.
Send the man up.
Hey, look.
That was my question. Do you think that was just like
a
generational thing? Because this millennial generation...
Look, man, here's
the problem. Without knowing what actually went down, you can't really say. Now, yeah, Stan older than dirt.
I can find what's in the...
As long as your employer has valid paperwork stating, hey, you were warned, and you didn't improve,
when the King of Comics tells you to get your shit together, get your shit together.
Exactly. Language.
That is not on the list.
That is on the list.
Is it on the list?
S&S.
It's only a two-word list, and you can't remember
it? That's don't not worry, on the I list. Probably remember it.
Jushin forwarded to me.
But you are correct.
If he tells you to get your stuff together, I mean, come on. You get a chance to work with a legend.
And he apparently, according to his lawsuit, they constantly reminded him of that. Like he should feel lucky that he got this job.
He should feel lucky he got that job.
He's working with an icon.
I'd go work for Stan right now.
Sign me up.
But if he disrespect me, I'm going to slap the ass out of Stan.
Take his cane.
You better keep your shit together. Smurf.
I mean, hey, I'm a man too, Stan.
And that's why no one says nothing to your ass when you walk in the church.
I'm social.
That's exactly why.
I'm very social.
Mm-hmm. Hey,
try online.
I wasn't trying to sell tickets.
You're giving away.
You can't give away tickets without people looking at your money.
It just has to be a woman that I talk to.
You guys want
to
see that Avengers team?
Why?
What's the thing?
Are you gonna think?
Why?
He thought it was a cat.
Did you even all say right,
so,
free?
Okay, oh, so here it is, here it is. So the kid's name is Sean Lucas Wick.
Punk.
Ass.
Sensitive punk.
Come on now.
Get Sean. Your ass off your mom's couch and get your own apartment.
You don't know what that man on his mom's couch
he probably is.
Keep reading. I better tell us.
His name is Sean Lukowicz. He claims Lee and his daughter and wife terrorize him for doing
and wife?
Three people?
Three people? Small.
Oh, hold on.
He says Stan Lee, his daughter, and Stanley's wife terrorized him during his stint as their personal assistant from November until June.
What you stayed so long for then?
Hold on. How can the 90-year-old man, and his wife probably old as hell too, and his daughter, which, how they gonna terrorize you?
His daughter is 65.
How the hell are they gonna terrorize you?
I'm sorry, three people told you that you are nothing, and you aren't worth it, and you did not improve. How do you fail to...
Keep going.
I don't know how the members of AARP is gonna terrorize you.
The suit filed Tuesday in Los Angeles, Superior Court claimed Lee's daughter, who's 65, told him to deliver some mail to Spider-Man co-creator's house. When he rang the bell, 92-year-old Lee allegedly answered the intercom and told him to get the F out and never ring my damn doorbell again.
Now that's some smart you would say that in a heartbeat. Don't ring my damn doorbell.
I don't have a doorbell.
I mean, if you didn't live in the backwoods,
here
you'd be telling
go.
Kids to get off
here
the damn lawn.
Here we go.
So, get that ball off my yard.
Hold on. He was paid $40 an hour for 40 what? Hours, but expected to be on call 24/7.
Oh, you can pay me that right now.
He said,
where do I sign up?
Said Lee ripped into him during a car ride to a meeting with boxer Manny Pacquiao, telling the assistant he was driving too slow.
So speed up! Or tell him say, bitch, I'm not Jason Statham.
He had 10 seconds there.
Hey, you wrote about Spider-Man and the Hulk. They better be in the back seat with you. Because when you finish that, I'm going to be on the news.
Was this the DC Comic Collection graphic novels?
Yeah.
You were talking about?
Yeah. We go over that.
That's probably what the title
said. He said when Pacquiao was a no-show, the suit says he was preparing to fly to Las Vegas for his May 1st fight with Floyd Mayweather. Lee flew into a Hulk-style rage.
Hulk-style at 92?
At 92.
It was probably...
Wait a minute. How standing?
You going to hell. You going to hell. I know I'm already going there, but you're going to have a seat right next to me for that.
What, you want to catch a piggyback ride?
Nah.
A Hulk-style rage?
Yes, Wicked. $40 an hour. So he flew into a Hulk-style rage, calling Lukowicz, whatever his name, an effing idiot, and saying everyone they work with thinks you're an effing a-hole. I say asshole. He thinks you're an effing asshole.
Apparently you read the memo too.
He wrote it.
So on a separate occasion, JC Lee, Stan's daughter, sent the assistant a text calling him a disloyal smirk.
He probably was reading DC Comics.
And also referred to him as a little bitch.
Well, he's acting like a little bitch.
He real sensitive.
She called him like she saw him.
He's real sensitive right now.
If his name wasn't Lukowicz, I would say he's light skinned. But not.
It couldn't have been too bad. It's in March. What was it? From
he
November.
He's still light skinned.
It was November to June, right?
Yeah.
November to June. In March, he was running errands for JC Lee, Stanley's daughter, to help her get ready for Easter, and he decided to buy her an Easter basket as a gift. So apparently, it couldn't have been too bad. Because if you don't deal with this from November to March, but you want to buy him a gift,
it only sounds like there's a handful of occasions where he was effing up.
And when he gave it to her, Lee purportedly. Yeah, that's what I said.
This is not meow.
We're going to get started.
She purportedly screamed, "You must be an effing retard. Why do I need an effing Easter bag?"
No. That's why you don't buy your bosses nothing.
First of all, the woman is 65 years old. I mean, really,
what are you buying her an Easter basket for? She's going to hide the eggs for you?
Maybe he was trying to holler. How old is he? Does it say?
He is...
I hope he's like... He has to be like 15, 16 maybe.
No, he's going to be like 24. Why?
He's 33.
No, he doesn't give his age. Not in this article.
You know what?
Okay, he acts 12.
But he looks older than me.
See, that right there?
He looks older than me.
That right there is the face of somebody whose parents have just let him get away with whatever they want.
He's not 15.
He's 33.
Hey, look, that Mickey Mouse Club dropout, okay?
If he's not 33, he's 42. I'm not going younger.
All right, let's move on.
Everybody.
This is when it came to a head. This is when it all ended. He said,
did Stan ask to make some pancakes?
really wicked.
What did Wicked say?
He tells Stan after his Muppet baby rage. to get 4 inches from his face and tell him he's about to cause his family a whole lot of pain. Save Stan for that. He said he picked Stan up with one arm and rattled shadow.
That's what... he's 92. Yeah, he's about to punch his ticket sooner or later. But look, I'm a grown man, Stan. I pull his cope and whoop your
feet. And this is where it all came to an end. This is what was the last straw when I guess Lee Lukowicz decided to quit. That he was tasked with driving Lee to San Francisco from Los Angeles.
That's a long drive.
What the hell's he driving to San Francisco for?
During a trip. During a trip, Lee smoked weed in the outside.
For glaucoma. Stop laughing.
It ain't funny.
Medicinal.
They smoked weed for the entire ride. And when they arrived at a hotel, her hotel, so that must be the daughter. I said, well, Stan, we smoked weed.
Woo! Where do you think Spider-Man came from?
Her hotel, she ordered to drive around the block a few times to air out the car. So when he complained he was not being paid for his extra time, she kicked him out of the car screaming, you're done, you're done.
She kicked him a 65 year. See?
He ended up abandoned in San Francisco and was forced to make it back to L.A. on his own.
Well, if you were being paid $40 for 40 hours, you actually had enough money to handle that. I'm sorry. I would have had
enough money. He's saying he wasn't paid for his overtime. He was paid to be on call 24/7, but he was only being paid for 40 hours. Now, that I get.
Okay,
I get that, but if you don't like that shit, quit.
There you go.
Some people can take that. Some people can't.
He didn't wake up and Stan called him and said, hey, here's a job for you today. He applied for this bus.
Yeah, and after day one, look, I'm with Ricky. If Stanley would have came and...
He and Candy baby. From Waffle House need to check themselves before they wreck themselves.
Nah. You ain't going to let that one go, Iron.
No,
Iron, good shot.
Look, Stanley went up a few points. When they talk about Stan Lee smoking weed on the trip from, when we thought it was Stan Lee smoking weed on the trip from L.A.
I'd have put that Snoop Dogg in. He was smoking the, man.
I'm gonna put this in.
Fuck, I got everything. Got it.
Don't worry about nothing, I'm Stan.
Oh, you ain't even gotta pay me for this trip.
So, what was this kid's name? Lukowicz. Sean.
Still talking about this one.
Sean Lukowicz. I'm with the fellas on this one. If you didn't like it, you stuck it out from November to June. I'm pretty sure at some point in that time frame, you knew it wasn't going to get any better than this.
Man, I'd have been stealing stuff from Stan House selling it on eBay.
At $40 an hour?
Yep.
You ain't the only one. I would have been stuck in LA. I can tell you how simple. I can tell you that. She would have put me out of the car. Like,
first of all, she wouldn't have put me out of the car.
First of all, she put me out of the car. I'm taking the keys with me.
Exactly.
what are you going to do? You 65, you going to whoop my ass? Come on.
You 65.
And you're high.
You going to whoop my ass? Get the fuck out of here. Smurf out of here. Come on.
So, what you going to do? What you going to do? And I would have called the police. You may need to check this out. Synonymous tip. done.
And that didn't make your nerd-kaboot?
That didn't make my nerd-kaboot.
That's a damn fine one.
I wanted to find out what the story was. I didn't get to read this one first. So,
now that we've taken an hour to get that out.
I know you ain't.
Yeah, actually, I am.
We don't care.
I know you don't care. That's what I'm just saying. I'm just saying.
Look like I care.
So what were the books then?
I gotta look that shit up again. I'm gonna close it out.
Memo.
Y'all were taking too damn long.
You need to resend a memo. I'm telling you.
Hey, look, man. I only keep this for only like 2 minutes, and then.
You asked, and he say we'll get right back to it.
That was 10 minutes ago.
He got a point there. You know his attention span, but
it's like he using his hotspot or something. He using your internet.
This might have been a change of password. You put everybody off.
Go to my hotspot.
But action figure news. Damn. Apparently Koto.
Who?
Koto Bukio.
Bukaya.
Yeah. That guy.
They've been knocking out some artifact statues. This is the first one I was called. Of magic. From the X-Men, and apparently they've already did a Cyclops, the Emma Frost, and the Magneto.
I think I've seen the Emma Frost. Looks good.
The magic is the one. It almost, because I picked up the Book of Ashanti from San Diego Comic Con 2015.
Yes, you did.
Yes, I did.
Yeah.
And that was one of the few magic figures that I've seen. And when they released this, it looks damn good. It does look good. So I may have to find a price tag on that. They usually drop to like $54.99 or something in that range.
Something in that range. Until they know you want it. Then it's $800. Oh, am I talking about the Hulk? The Hulkbuster, I'm sorry.
It'd be damned if I pay $800 for a
second rate X-Man.
But because I was also eyeballing a Nightwing. By Koto Bukio.
A who?
Nightwing.
Nightwing!
The only thing that's drawing me back is he's in the red costume. So I'm like,
You can paint it blue.
Not if you pay $54 for it.
It can be custom made.
Oh, and this one is right up Wicked Alley. They're re-releasing, or juicing. They're revising. Maddie Collector and Four Horsemen are revising their Lionel Thundercat figure. And re-releasing it. Now, I know Wicked is the Maddie Collector.
I've been there a couple times.
You've been there a couple times? I picked up the Maddie Collector too. I picked up the one I was halfway. The Rotor and Twister. I picked those up. Who they are? Here's a side note.
I was waiting for the explanation.
I haven't seen them in Masters of the Universe before, so
what was the name?
Rotor and Twistoid?
Yeah, you got people.
Like I said, because Wicked has all kinds of magic collectors.
Wicked probably told you to get
the Masters of the Universe, and a few of the characters he got, I haven't even heard of. I wasn't too keen on Jitsu until I seen him over at Wicked.
And he still had the ponytail.
And he still had the ponytail.
You know if the house burned down. There's only two artifacts you have to get. Colossus? No. Juggernaut and Jitsu.
Juggernaut and Jitsu. There's only two that you pick up.
That's the only ones you have to pick up. The rest can run out on their own.
So keep an eye out for that. No release date on when it's going to drop in the store. They just put the word out that everybody's going to. It looks pretty good. I don't know if it was a resculpt. Or they touched up some of the hair on Lionel, but it looks pretty damn good.
No, that's not the one that looks like the furry Lionel, is it?
No. There's no authentic animal fur on this Lionel. Last thing on our action figure kick is Hot Toys is putting out a Boba Fett. And it comes with a Sarlacc pit.
You awake over there?
Oh, I'm awake. I haven't seen that one yet, though.
You haven't seen that one? Because somebody, earlier this week, somebody...
I saw the Samurai Boba Fett.
Yeah, somebody put up a picture of the Samurai Boba Fett.
I saw that one.
but I don't think that was by Hot Toys.
No, it was someone else.
We know all this time Hot Toys has been doing it right.
Well, that's because they have Dr. Voodoo in the back, cranking them out.
But no, I haven't seen the Sarlacc one yet.
Yeah, it's a one-stick scale. He comes with his jetpack.
The researcher did that?
So with his jetpack.
There's porn on here.
There's not porn.
CBR does not contain one. What you got? How many windows you got open here?
I'm trying to keep this damn thing back up.
Thank you. You need a mouse?
I got one. It's not using it. It's right there.
Yeah,
I know. I ain't got space for it.
I ain't got space.
Look, you talking to the same guy where he was like, now I gotta go buy that damn book so I can see where all the Riddler trophies are. And you're like, you know, it's on the internet. I don't read the internet. Alright. Alright.
And he bought the book, didn't he?
Hey, I'm only maybe 50 something trophies left.
Yeah.
Making way.
You bring the book to the crib.
Making way. Okay.
Did you find him yet?
I found a picture.
I thought the Sarlacc pit had more tentacles than that.
It did. But you're looking at 1/6 scale, so
okay.
You gotta remember.
Everything.
Yeah. It looks a little smaller. Objects are smaller than they really appear.
Not good.
Not good at all.
Not good.
You don't think so?
Nah.
You still have to get it.
No, I don't.
What you do?
No, I don't.
Considering that the Sarlacc
pit not a real
is large enough to swallow more than
I'm a real. Time. I'm gonna spend my money on something quality.
This.
So what is it about that putting you off?
The Sarlacc is
small. Sarlacc's way too small.
It needs to be bigger.
Way too small, not enough tentacles. It just doesn't do it.
It's large enough to at least swallow 3 or 4 people together by in one.
That looks like
they put like a G.I. Joe figure right above it.
And just repainted it.
And repainted it. Yep.
Put some Ghostbusters, like chandelier ghost tentacles there. But there we go.
So, work?
No, I don't own anything Star Wars except the DVD.
And that's your problem right there, young man. If you own more Star Wars, you'd be more affable to the public.
That's probably true.
I don't have a problem with the public.
What was that word?
The public got problems with you?
Salubrious.
Salubrious. Okay, so I found your graphic novel again.
Shoot. Knock them off the boat. You want me?
It's yours.
You just researched it. You on the laptop.
What do you want to talk about it?
Just the title.
Graphic novels. The titles to the graphic novel animated films that come together in there.
This bitch really read the title.
Sad part about it is you said it. You asked. The one you don't remember what? Who that
happened to. Oh, I'm sorry. You meant the title of the comics.
You are bad.
This is not the title of the comics. You should have said something.
So it's The Death of Superman, yeah. Batman Black and White,
Batman
Year One. Now this bitch want to take it.
Go ahead,
my bad. I get 3 D's. And then you want to get a unit.
You can finish.
Whatever you say out loud, he's just going to mouth it over there.
JLA Earth 2, Justice League, and Wonder Woman. You can either buy them individually or as a set. So they are the graphic novels, and they also come with the related movies. Which doesn't say which movies are coming, but that's the source material.
They should, because all of these had movies.
Of course, the Wonder Woman is the Wonder Woman one, the Batman Year One. But the black and white, which one was the Death of Superman?
It was the Death of Superman, because it was the one where Doomsday killed him, but then it came back and Superman was killing people, but then it was just...
So, if you already have these DVDs, they're coming out on Blu-ray.
Yeah. Yes, they are.
The first two ones were...
But you may not have the graphic novel. I think the JLA Earth 2 graphic novel is on Chrysler Field.
Yeah, that's the movie.
So pick them up.
Or don't.
I guess the T1 Mobile 2000.
What's the price tag on those?
What was that, six?
All six, $149.
What?
$145.
Just kidding.
Now, individually, $2,600. So it's not bad. You get a novel and a DVD. Or a Blu-ray. That might be in the second set.
Maybe.
Well, I'll pass that on to Nightwing.
Nightwing!
He's not gonna buy it, though.
He'll
buy Godzilla in 3D.
Hey, just because that man likes Godzilla.
He likes trash, that's what it is.
Really, don't mince words. Tell us how you really feel.
Oh, yeah.
Is he listening?
Probably not.
Was not anymore.
Probably not. Because I asked him, I was at work, say, hey, you going to check out the show tonight? What time y'all come on? I was like, bitch, the same time every week.
So, but, on to movie news. What's the movie news worth?
Straight out of Compton? Oh, that doesn't fit here. It fits on my nerve, guys.
Stay in your neck of the woods.
But, also that came out today was The Man from U.N.C.L.E.
Right.
Sure, I didn't want to see that.
Are we watching that on Sunday?
I thought we were straight out of Compton on Sunday.
I'm straight out of Compton on Saturday.
Oh, we might as well go straight out of Compton on Saturday and then go to on Sunday.
10 o'clock. 10:05.
On Saturday? Can't be 10:05 on Saturday.
You'll be at work?
No, I promised Black Beauty I'd take it to the Riverside Arts.
Okay. Your best bet is going to Riverside Art Park.
Damn it, you know I've done this for 35 years. I know. So movie news. Especially for Flash, Arrow, Supergirl. They've been announcing casting like crazy this whole week.
I don't know how they're going to maintain this season. It's an hour. And it sounds like it needs to be 2 hours. An episode.
Yeah, everything they're releasing, it's just...
Hey, that just means it's going
especially bad. Season 2 of Flash.
That much better.
Have you watched Flash yet?
Haven't watched Flash yet because I wanted to start it, but LJ decided we're going to start Arrow.
Really?
No, you can't start Flash.
I'm already 8 episodes into Arrow.
Okay, you can stop.
I gotta say though, it ain't bad.
It's not.
It gets worse.
Yeah, yeah, but you on season 1.
I know. You easily stop.
You could have did season 1 of Flash.
You know what?
And done.
Yeah, you know what? Here's the thing. Get your laptop and you watch Flash while she's watching Arrow.
First of all, I'm not taking any advice from this side of the table right here. Boy, in this area, sector.
You whatever. Listen to him, your Kusanagi stock going to go way down.
Exactly.
It's going to plummet.
But first off, it was Lutina Weston. And for those who don't know who that is, she played Tara in True Blood.
I know right now Wicked doing that Tara slave run.
And Parker Young are both being cast for Arrow Season 4. Lutina Weston is one that she's supposed to play Lady Cop. I think she's just recently introduced into the Green Arrow mythos. And Parker Young is a new character who's supposed to be a love interest for the sister, Thea.
I thought she was with Roy.
He died, didn't he? Well, he's in jail.
No, Roy's running. No, Roy's free. Everyone,
Roy, out and about. Roy's over in Bloodhaven.
Team up. Bloodhaven.
You said a female as a love interest for Thea?
No, Parker Young. He's not a female.
Okay.
Thought this was Barbara Gordon all over again.
No.
Why'd you get that heckle when he said Barbara Gordon all over again?
Don't worry about it.
You enjoy that, didn't you? You nasty bitch. I know. We got a first look at the Jay Garrick costume for Flash Season 2. Anybody check that out? And I did. I checked it out because they did a side-by-side comparison of the comic. And the concept reveal. For the, yeah. So it was pretty much straight on. I would say the lines on the lightning bolt would be a little thicker, a little fuller. It wasn't colored in like it was, but other than that, it was straight on. So, and I'm kind of interested to see what made Professor Zoom like, all right, it's time for me to get the hell out of here. On that final episode, that helmet came through the portal. Everybody else was like,
hey, it was like that? It was like he heard his mama car pull up.
Yeah. That helmet came in. Everybody was like, what is that? That's my cue. It's time for me to get the hell out of here.
Hold on.
So, Jushin, did you see the Flash costume?
Yes, I did.
For Jay Garrick. And your thoughts?
Swag. Flash and Legends of Tomorrow is going to be the only thing I'm watching next year.
And Legends of Tomorrow? You going to give it a try?
Yeah, I'm going to give
it a try. But no Jessica Jones.
I'm just not going to watch Jessica Jones or Arrow.
Apparently, they're calling Jessica Jones the darkest series that Netflix has ever produced.
They are. Now. And they also say that they're going to go all...
They're going to be some butt naked women in there.
So, there were butt naked women in Powers, weren't there?
No.
Well, then, nope.
That's why you didn't watch it.
Although, I'm not going to watch it. There was butt naked women in Marco Polo. I love that.
You watch Marco Polo.
I did watch Marco Polo.
What is this argument? Yeah,
that comparison doesn't
work. How does that work? Look, how does that work?
Here's the thing.
So, because you love Marco Polo, you secretly say you're going to love Jessica Jones.
No. Yeah. Butt naked women doesn't mean it sold itself to me. Jessica Jones is not something that's going to endear itself to me.
That's exactly what it is. From the statement you just said, that's exactly what it means. Marco Polo had butt naked women. I loved it.
But not Jessica Jones.
It's okay, Juicy.
I don't care if
it's okay, Juicy. You can watch it by yourself. You don't have to.
I'm not going
to
watch it at all.
Okay. We believe you.
He's just not going to tell me.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Believe what you want. Moving on.
He's going to slip one day.
They go midget.
And we'll be like, did y'all see Jessica Jones? He'll be like, yeah.
Juicy.
Juicy. Yeah. All right. Moving on.
So Tom Hardy was, had a scene in Suicide Squad. He was cast in Suicide Squad.
Oh,
he was cast in Suicide Squad.
I didn't know this. They were saying he was slated to play the part of Rick Flag in Suicide Squad. But apparently now he's been dropped. It's not Tom Hardy anymore because he's going to be producing 100 Bullets, which is a Vertigo title. 100 Bullets. And 100 Bullets is like a, not to sound cliche, but like a secret organization of hitmen, dating all the way back to, what was the Pilgrim Society that came over? They settled.
Plymouth Rock?
No, not Plymouth Rock.
Roanoke?
Yeah, they settled, and then when everyone else came to look for them, the whole settlement was the zone, and there was nobody there. And no one ever found out what happened to him. Yeah, the only word that was found, like carved into a tree or something like that, was Scrotoa. And that's where the Hitman Society dates back to.
So, are we implying that they're the society?
No, they're not the society, but apparently it has something to do with it. I have to go back and reread because I read it earlier and I didn't understand it. But I have all the volumes right there. $100. First shot, last call.
I've never heard of it until...
I saw it on the show.
Well, that's because you've been digging through the show.
That's why I saw it on the show.
The Vertigo title.
I tried to read it and didn't hold on to it.
Who do I thought?
It probably wasn't a butt-naked woman.
Oh, it's butt-naked woman.
That's...
sure is. Butt-naked women.
So he's turned away from two?
And that's page three.
So it is possible for him to.
Women. So Agent 33 is like, if you don't partake, I will.
And he went straight to page 3. He was,
I overshot. There we go.
Scene 16, monsters ball. So, Constantine is not dead.
Isn't he supposed to show up in a another successful show?
Supposed to appear in Arrow this season.
Yep.
And it's the same actor, Matt Ryan, who plays Constantine in the short-lived Constantine. He's supposed to show up in Arrow, and the rumor is he's going to have something to do with, spoiler alert, White Canary.
Yeah, I saw that.
Dinah Lance coming back.
Probably. Wouldn't be surprised.
What did Arrow do to you? You're so away from Arrow now.
I don't even care.
You're a very jaded individual.
Well, it's because I've been through Smallville, and right now Arrow is going right through the same Smallville cycle, so I'm like,
I can't fault him for that.
I'm dumping off now.
Because I didn't want to give Arrow a try because of Smallville.
That's like saying you don't want to give any of the rest of them a try because of Smallville.
Well, see,
it was the same premise.
I never got caught up in Smallville.
I didn't either, so I...
It was the same premise. The whole, pretty much like Batman Year One, Superman Year One, but Superman Year One lasted for 10 seasons, and he didn't become Superman because the actor didn't want to wear the cape.
Oh, so he was getting paid $40 an hour, huh?
Yeah, the whole love triangle thing, it went on for 10 seasons, and it drove me crazy.
Yeah, they moved one girl out, moved another girl in.
What I'm getting tired of on Arrow is all of the not wanting to embrace his self.
The vigilante?
Yeah.
Hugging himself or just, oh.
He's talking about the vigilante. He doesn't, are you saying he doesn't want to become the vigilante or he doesn't want to become Green Arrow?
He doesn't want to, you know, when he came, When I first started watching it, and he came home and he was putting arrows through people, I was like, yes!
Yeah. So this changes, because I'm right at the point of them putting in some arrows to people, and I'm all about, yeah!
You might want to.
Spoiler alert!
Earmuffs.
then he starts shooting sticks with marshmallows on the end of them, and I'm like, man, what is going on? Wow.
I haven't seen the third
season. He just starts shooting for non-lethal in areas. Non-killing.
Hey, I'm like, put him down,
bro. Hey, look. This is the problem with Batman. You got criminals, these highly psychotic criminals that repeatedly escape Arkham, repeatedly, and keep endangering people's lives and killing them. He is at fault.
You might as well put a damn revolving door on Arkham.
That is the true statement.
Because if you put him in there, you might as well schedule him in for next week.
What?
But if you put them down,
sell comics next year, though,
you
right?
Put them down,
so, you know,
you ain't got to worry about it.
But can't you create more villains?
You can.
How many people would you have saved if you had killed the Joker the first time?
Hey, like the Joker has to say,
I would have threw a batarang and cracked it in his ass.
Hey, look, he got dropped into a bat of ass for the first time. I would have dropped him into a second one the second time.
Well, obviously it didn't work
Make
the first
sure
time.
Yeah, I would have sat him in there too. I wouldn't have drained that whole vent down. Exactly.
I'm sorry. But y'all gonna make the Joker blow the wicked whistle. Y'all gonna quit talking about the Joker, I'm telling you.
Don't get me wrong, I love Joker, but...
Oh, don't love him now, bitch.
Yeah, don't backpedal now. Just because he invoked Wicked's name, don't backpedal now. Stick with your guns.
I've been choked out by Wicked.
Stick with those guns.
I'm okay with it. We're
just talking about the Joker, we can't talk about Blade.
Joker, I love you, psychotic, but I'm just saying, as a real... If he had just stopped him the first time and just stopped taking him back, save plenty of people's lives. Jason people Todd. Get killed every week because you failed to stop them, finally.
Jason Todd, Barbara Gordon's leg.
Come on now, that's on you.
Hey, what I don't understand is Bruce's, I don't want to shoot anybody because my parents got shot. He never said he didn't want to kill anybody because his parents got killed. hostage is because they were shot. That's why he doesn't use guns.
All right.
Okay. You don't have to kill them, but hey, they can eat fried chicken through a straw.
Yes, they can. Incapacitate,
something to make him think about the next time. He'd be like, I'm gonna take these chains. Nah, I ain't gonna do that. Last time, Batman. I rub it faster, Batman. Something to give him, you know, just give him pause.
I mean, hey, now, we all know Wicked. And he always says, you know, if there's something that scares him or makes him jump, he gonna take it, put it in the microwave for 3 days. Just so it know, hey, just to scramble the brains a little bit. Now go tell your friends about it. That's all Batman gotta do. That's it.
Just one time.
Go tell your friends.
Probably take one time, maybe twice, because you know them Smurfers and Gotham are crazy.
Yes.
Overly so.
But I'm telling you.
He is an enabler. It's a habit.
If somebody eating fried chicken through a straw, they gonna tell somebody. You know, hey.
Like, man, what happened to you? Hold on, this fried chicken good as much.
Hey, don't do that. Do not do.
Hey, that's all you gotta do. Listen to your sidekicks. Listen to your T-Mobiles. Cause then the sidekicks, they're like, hey, we need to lay these people down.
Yep. Completely agree. He is just an enabler of habit.
I want to argue with you, but I can't. Just because it's you, and I, you know, isn't I just want to argue, but.
Isn't it cold in hell with you, right?
Hell just froze over real quick. Oh. Need to warm things up real quick. Oh.
So that was a little bit of casting news for Flash and Arrow. They also beefing up Supergirl. Livewire is supposed to make an appearance. And she originally showed up in Superman.
Who is Livewire?
Livewire is she's a female. Remember,
she's a female Electro.
Superman
Blue? The Electric Superman?
Oh. She's a female Electro.
She's like that.
He looked it up. He researched that. That's what he came up with.
Dude, she was in Superman animated series.
Livewire. She's an electric kid.
Did you see the Superman animated series?
Electric, just because I know some big words.
Electrical. Livewire.
We got to get you on point. You can see Justice League Unlimited either, dude.
That's on Netflix, huh?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't seen that.
It's queued up.
I haven't seen that.
Is that maybe Power Rangers?
If I could delete Power Rangers, y'all ruin Power Rangers for me, man. That's you too. I don't know that I'm watching any more shows next week.
I don't know why you're watching to begin with.
The only thing I said is that Black Ranger is missing the middle. That's it.
Did you know that?
Hell no, I don't watch that.
But did you know it?
If I don't watch it, then how the hell am I going to know it?
Because he probably was in something else. Wrong. I ain't seen his ass either.
He did actually have a short acting career on something else afterwards, but I can't remember the name.
What was it? It was for 4 minutes?
You want to help out, too?
I don't agree with him, but yeah, you are.
Now, Livewire is supposed to be played by Britt Morgan, who was also in True Blood as Alcide, the werewolf.
Alcide, whatever. Wasn't she a crackhead or something? Yeah. No, she's my bad. It wasn't crackhead. It was V.
She was the addict, the werewolf addict.
But people who've never seen a crackhead, that's what they act like.
So a new Lego Batman movie is coming out, starring the Joker.
Did you see who was going to voice him?
Voiced by Zach Galifianakis.
That's horrible. That's just wrong.
Is that forecasting?
That's horrible.
Because Hamill's tied up with Star Wars. So who else are you going to get?
Who?
Mark Hamill. That could have with Star Wars.
You know what?
Picked so many.
The guy who voiced Frieza. He plays a good criminal.
That's how his voice is with Star Wars. Frieza's voice is always the soft to me. For him,
but we're talking about Lego characters, so.
Well, so Frieza to be as this badass villain, his voice was a little soft. I'm just saying.
Did you see that you can now play Legos on your phone?
No, I didn't.
I play them on my Xbox. I don't need to play them on your phone.
Just letting you know that you can now team up with Wicked. If you can get him to put it on his phone, you can team up with him.
Nah, I'm good, man. I'm good.
I put Legos on your phone.
Why don't they say Legos, playing Legos would lead you to child pornography? Why don't they say that?
Probably doesn't.
Neither does anime.
I know.
Leo Fitzpatrick's gonna have a recurring role on Gotham. They created a villain for him. He's leading a gang of arsonists, and some people are speculating that this is gonna tie into the Batman villain Firefly. They haven't officially said. Do they have a name for Firefly?
Yeah, his name is Arthur Batman.
When's Gotham start? September?
I thought it was October.
Is it October?
Are you gonna be caught up by then?
Oh, I'm already caught up in Gotham. I'm good with that.
This one gonna be caught up.
I'm still 4 episodes.
You only 4 episodes in?
No, I'm only 4 episodes left.
Oh, okay. Well, you need to be caught up.
I'm gonna text you my answer to say yeah.
I don't need to know your answer.
We already know.
It's probably right up there with Destiny.
My answer was gonna be soon as
he'll watch Gotham when I watch
Jessica Jones.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you ain't watching Gotham, man.
Exactly.
Lucky you. Man, it's not bad, but it's also the man that sat through Powers. Maybe that's because I didn't read it.
You sit through Powers, you can sit through anything.
Well, I can't sit through another Fantastic Four movie, I can tell you that.
I didn't sit through the first one, so.
I should have known something was up. I don't recall seeing the Marvel comic at the beginning.
That is true.
Garfield Lynn.
That's bad. Well, whoever they cast Leo Fitzpatrick to play that wasn't the name. We got a first look at the Black Panther costume from Captain America Civil War this week. I'm hoping they add some CGI to it. It looks a little...
CGI less?
Slim?
Yeah.
Little lacking.
Luster. Looks a little.
Meanwhile, Cap looks all finished. Muscular.
No, he did. Like he stuck some tissue in the mask or something. But, yeah, the Black Panther costume looks a little slim, and I ain't gonna appreciate it if they didn't wore like that. He's already supposed to show up in Age of Ultron, and he didn't.
Well, you know, they left that Easter egg in there with claw. He actually has to have a claw now. Because Ultron lasered his arm.
That was funny.
It was funny. I'm sorry.
Oh, damn, my bad. Oh, I didn't mean to be. I didn't know that was going to come off. Here, let's see. Let's see if we can put this back on. And lastly, Flash Season 2 is casting. There's no word of who's going to play her yet, but the female Dr. Light.
Yeah, I saw that.
Not opposed to the, or as opposed to the male Dr. Light, who's the homicidal rapist, the serial rapist, who they chose to lobotomize when Batman found out, so they lobotomized Batman.
What?
Yeah.
He came up to the squash tower, beginning to mess around with things.
Everyone was always asking the question, why was Batman so, not really paranoid, but so suspicious of everyone? Why he always had a plan to take down the next hero or villain or backup plan?
Because that makes sense.
No, it was because when he first joined the Justice League, the villain, Dr. Light, found his way onto the watchtower. And found
Raped Sue Dibny, the wife of Elongated.
Elongated and Raped Sue Dibny.
How you follow the Elongated Man?
That's apparently.
Hey, he tried. He's made a light.
So they came back and found him on the watchtower, and he started figuring out who everybody was. He saw the wedding ring under Barry Allen, under his costume, and he was like, how long is this going to find your wife? Everybody was like, we gotta do something about this. And they used the Tana to alter his memory, make him an idiot, pretty much. And Batman was like, no, this isn't right, you're not gonna do that. So what do? They erase, they mind wipe him, like 10 minutes of his memory. So he knew something wasn't right, but he couldn't figure out what it was, so he didn't trust anybody after that.
I just like.
Ooh!
I just like when I was younger. When Batman said to Superman, like, he was like, you don't have a plan? He's like, no.
Idiot.
Or something he said. I was like, kind of makes sense.
Yeah.
I'd have a backup plan for this, but if he planning against me, I'm going to plan against him.
Because you know what, they actually asked him that towards the end of that movie. They was like, well, what's the backup plan for Batman when Batman goes rogue? He was like, we already have one, it's called the Justice League. We're like, damn, have to take all of them to get down Batman. So Jushin, we went and saw Fantastic Four. I didn't see it.
You're not gonna see it.
Like, Agent, did you get a chance to check out Fantastic Four?
No. Okay, so let me talk about it.
Word. Yes, please.
And Jushin went and saw Fantastic Four.
Shogun was there, too.
Again, and Shogun was there. And again, Jushin wrote an article on it. If you want to check it out, you can go to thedirectedition.com and give it a look over. But all in all, if you had to give it a grade, let's go Wicked Style. If you had to give it a grade, let's start off with this. What grade would you give it?
On our alphabet scale?
On
minus.
On bad bitches and koala rafts.
Zero bad bitches, 7 koala rafts.
It only goes to 5 koala rafts.
Not anymore.
Stakes have been up, Jerry. That's how
zero
rough
it's going. And 7 koala rafts.
I honestly thought it started off great, and then it just went downhill so fast, it just... I couldn't believe they made that movie. And they put it out in theaters.
So what's your grade?
Using bad bitches and koala rafts?
Jushin gave it a D. 0 bad bitches and 7 koala rafts.
-6 bad bitches. Because it's in the minus.
Is that bad?
13 koala rafts.
Damn.
So, here's the thing.
Do I even want to wait till this come on DVD to watch?
You don't. You buy the DVD and just go ahead and burn that.
You'd be better off. Let's see. It was how many minutes was it?
90.
Okay. From here on out, this is how I'm gonna rate movies. Cause the Shogun was sitting next to me, and she said, "How long do you think this movie is going?" My answer was,
if it's a good movie,
it was just long enough.
But if it was a bad movie,
it was too long.
So when you hear people shuffling in their seats, it's too long.
No. When you're thinking about,
damn,
what you need to buy from the grocery store,
thinking about you need to go home, mow the grass,
or wondering what's going on and what's playing in the next theater over.
If you forget that you're in the theater, if for some reason you feel like it's okay to go use the bathroom because I'm not gonna miss anything.
you go to the bathroom. You don't rush coming back. You wash your hands. You put your hands through the air blower twice just to make sure that it's clean.
If at the end of the movie you really think that you watched a Marvel movie. And you're really still waiting on Stan Lee to show up?
Because he didn't show.
And there's no post credits, but you didn't Google to see if there were any? It's probably not a good movie.
Probably not a good movie. You sitting there in the seats.
So you're there too long.
Listening to the sound effects. Now here's the
thing. I knew Stanley wasn't going to have a scene because he stopped doing Sting. He said,
Sting.
He said Ant-Man was going to be his last scene.
Oh, or did he now?
His last sneak into a movie into a scene.
That was a lie. He just didn't want to do anything fantastic.
I don't think he was doing anything else. Fantastic Four.
He was too busy punking Sean.
Probably. But Fantastic Four was... They took the concept, the core concept from the Ultimate storyline to modernize the story. Kids who building this device into the, you know, in a bridge into an alternate universe, a teleporter.
Yeah, because I read the Ultimate one.
Yeah. They took that main story, and that's how the origin started. But then they get over there, and you leave Dr. Doom behind.
But wait. Here's when you realize you're not really watching a comic book movie. When the first action scene is basically when they teleport over there.
Which is almost like an hour into the movie.
They teleport over there. There's a reaction on this planet.
Things explode.
That's your action.
You lose a man. You try to get back.
So do you remember the scene in Armageddon when they're drilling? And it's like a earthquake type thing, and there's pieces falling out. It was like the gas bubble.
When they get to the ice, when they get to the asteroid.
Yeah.
Put that scene in Fantastic Four, and that's your first action scene. Has nothing to do with their powers, anything like that. That's it right there. So then after that.
And that's an hour in?
Yeah. I wouldn't say an hour.
Maybe
I'd 45 say
minutes.
It took too long to get to it.
Yeah.
Okay. So after that happens, they come back. Doom's still over there.
They left him behind because they thought he died.
He got trapped in the
Sue didn't have to do anything to get her
secret
powers.
Of the ooze. Because it was the ooze that got it.
Sue didn't have to do anything to get her powers. She didn't even go.
She just stand there.
She just hit the button to bring him back, and that's when she got powers.
Yeah, they came back and there was like this magnetic explosion and it hit her.
Backlash of energy, she got hit. How did that
give her powers though?
Your best friend, me and you, say, you know, cause we've grown up and we've known each other more than 20 years. We go
I
over
don't
there.
Tell many people that,
I'm just saying. We go over to this dimension, we
that
come
was
back.
Knowledge.
You wake up, I wake up, I crawl through a duct and I see you trapped in this room, rock creature asking for help. And I leave you behind. How would you feel?
But how if I just
well,
woke
hold on,
up,
hold on, hold on,
if I just
hold
woke
on.
Up, how do I know that's you?
Because he,
you
he,
said your name. I yeah. said your name.
Hold on, hold on, hold on.
He's like Ben, and he turns and he's like, "Help!" So,
he even said his name.
He said, "I'll be back." Left him.
Gone.
Now this is when we find out.
Did he go back?
Hell no.
Wait. This is when we find out how long your ass been gone. It comes up on the screen a year later.
Oh, dang.
You still on the wanted list.
Don't come back to me. I don't want that. Why would you want to go? I'm back. I'll tell you what.
I'll be right back.
And here's another thing. Sue dined on twice.
Hey, she's a certified snitch.
The first time when she found out that they used it to go to the other dimension, call dad.
Yeah, use her to go over to
No, the they room. used the machine to teleport. Because Victor was like, okay, can you tell me
how do you know he's still alive?
No, this was before they went. Before they went, they found out that when they finally got it working and it came back and it was a successful mission because you know they sent the chimp over there.
Alright.
Brought the chimp back, he was fine. So then
chimp didn't get no powers?
Chimp got no power.
I've been pissed off. Chimp out of bitch. How y'all send me over there? Y'all come back with all this. And I don't come back with nothing.
So then they're like, okay, we're going to get a team together. So Vic and them like, wait a minute. We were going to go.
They were all on the assumption that they were going to go.
Yeah. And oh, like, so the Baxter building or whatever they were working at, they were like, we're going to get a team.
Yeah, we're going to get actual astronauts to go.
Okay.
Right. You guys are scientists who put this together.
So Victor takes him in the room and he's like, look, we've been to the moon. Can you name the person that built the spaceship? And they were like,
hell no.
No. Say, but you know Neil Armstrong, right? Like, Buzz. Yeah. He's like, yeah. Said, but the guy that built the spaceship, he's sitting around a bar telling people he built the spaceship, but nobody knows. So,
good Reed's point. Like, that's a good damn point.
Reed's like, that's going to be me. Victor's like, no, that's going to be me. So Johnny says, no, that's us. So then they, you know, they back there, they drinking. So here it comes. Like, why don't we go? So he called his boy Ben. Ben, get him. It's 2 o'clock. Ben ain't even there.
Shit, what's up, man?
Ben had to tell his old lady it's Jake from State Farm.
Where cat?
Ben, we finna take a trip. Oh, y'all going to the moon? No, we going next door. The next dimension, baby. So they call Ben up.
So Ben gets there. They get all suited up. And that's when all the... When they were coming back, Ben's door on his pod
opened. Could not close.
First off, it was closed, then it opened.
Yeah.
How the hell that happened?
So he's over there fighting and trying to close. Now all these rocks are coming in.
I will slap Smurf out of Johnny. Did he build it?
Nah, yeah, kind of.
Well,
yeah,
Reed and Johnny.
We would have got out the door. Ben, you alright? Ben, you
So in Johnny's pod, he caught on fire.
Okay, I see this. Oh, so in Reed's pod,
there was a bunch of rubber bands, or he was playing T.I.'s Rubber Band Man. So I don't know how.
He kept a stack on himself.
So what happened in Victor's pod? If that was the thing that
Victor,
was going on.
Victor, pod.
He was just
he got an ooze. He ran into the shredder too.
He was part of the foot playing all that.
Oh. So they bring these kids back. And they're victims of their powers. They don't know how to control them.
Okay.
So, except for, you know, like, Ben kind of gets used to moving around with it. So, they use him for military operations.
Black ops missions.
And you know what?
That we don't see any of that action, but on the TV. We're watching a movie, watching them watch a movie. So, that's the second action scene.
That's the second action scene.
Yes.
That you had to see them watch.
Third action scene was they found Reed because of the certified snitch.
She said she could find him.
Yeah.
Went looking for it on the net.
How did she find him?
Because she can predict people's patterns. Everybody has a pattern.
Hey, I didn't think Reed was that dumb to be found on
the net. Apparently he had left a little cookie hot door and told her to take the book of 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. She found an access, like a little, what was it, Captain Nemo? Found his ass.
That's some bullshit.
Dined him out, and guess who went to go get his ass?
Ben.
Yep.
Me too. I would have went. Bro. I would have went too.
So Ben headbutted him after he knocked out all the other soldiers that went. Ben didn't knock him out. Reed did.
Okay.
So he had gotten adapted with his powers because he had created all these metal bracelets he put all over.
Rubber band coil.
What were they supposed to do?
Allowed so he can help retract. Him bring or retract himself back.
Because he didn't know how to retract.
He has to focus really hard in order to pull himself back together.
Bitch, practice! Not a year!
But here's the thing. Without his suit, Johnny can stay on flame. He has to keep the suit on to turn his power off.
Wait.
What's wrong with that?
And he has a switch.
Does he burn?
No, he has a switch.
So while he's on fire, he doesn't burn.
He doesn't burn. But he has a switch. He doesn't turn it off. He's like Batman. There's something on his suit that he turns off.
Pretty much, Johnny was like the lighter. You like the barbecue.
Yes. He was like Dick Lighter.
There we go. Dick Lighter.
Yes. And his action scene, if we want to call him.
I saw him come around in the trailer. I saw him come around the corner and fireball somebody.
Well, yeah, that was his sister. That's the last. And that was his sister.
Oh, yeah, that was his
that
sister.
That was Sue.
Mr. Smith's done too many times.
So, we're on... That scene would have been the fifth action scene.
Yeah.
All right. So how did they find out that Doom is still alive?
Because they could not get the teleporter to work without Reed. The whole year he was gone, they couldn't get the damn thing to work.
So they had to go get Reed. That's why they were hunting Reed. Not because they wanted him to come put this team together and protect the Earth.
Powers. No, they wanted his mind.
They wanted his mind to fix this so we can actually go back to this planet so we can try to save Earth.
So they sit his ass in a room.
Save Earth from what?
From itself.
Because apparently we messed it up. But over there, there's new untapped natural resources that haven't been spoiled. That's the whole set. So who do they send in the room? They send him down the room. Who they send in to talk to there? The snitch. They send the snitch in to talk him in the joint.
That's that Kuzunagi,
man. No, send the snitch to talk to me. You don't buy me out. You want to come talk to the hand? You need your help.
That's the Kuzunagi.
No, so he helped them. He turned the machine on for them. They went back over there.
With the people they wanted to send to begin with.
Who did they find?
They went back with the astronauts.
Yes. Okay. Who did they find?
They found Victor.
What has Victor been doing this whole time?
Apparently they brought his ass back.
Actually, I think he was sewing a hoodie because when they got back, when they got over there, he was wearing this
hoodie. That,
you remember what Megatron had on when he had all the roaches caught?
Yeah, it was in the third one. In the third, yes.
He was wearing that?
He was wearing that. So I guess he found Cybertron. So then they bring him back. And of course, you know, they got to examine him and all that, or they try, they attempt. Well, they got him strapped in. Well, of course, he's so powerful that nobody can contain him here.
Yeah, he's the source of all the power now. He's been in there, so he basically starts killing people.
So the ooze was the source of all the power.
Yes. Right. Secret of the ooze. You see how we tying all these movies in there? Because we're trying to make it a better movie.
And
you take out these other movies, and you just got some mediocre BS. Which, basically, we sat through mediocre BS. Because the main action scene was at the end of the damn movie.
When he wakes up, that's when it starts. When Victor wakes up.
When Victor wakes up.
So he wakes up, starts killing people, because he wants to go back. He doesn't want no one to follow him. He starts killing people, making his way back to this machine. Everyone eventually gathers there
in the
room where the machine, and he picks the machine, and he goes back to the other universe.
Creates a black hole.
And begins pulling
Not another
Earth.
Damn black
yes,
hole.
Another damn black hole.
And begins pulling Earth into that one.
Didn't somebody see that it worked with Man of Steel?
No!
They did not. So they thought they could do it better. So, what do? They have to put a bubble around the three of them while Johnny flies behind.
And they go over there. They go through the hole to get to where Victor is.
And he proceeds to whip the jelly asses.
Because they try to attack him separately.
Oh, they got to do it as a team.
Yes. So then they do it as a team.
And they win.
Then the credits roll.
I think at that point you probably like think on.
Oh, yeah. It was too long to not be long enough.
So,
and it was only 100 minutes. Because when I was like, they just found him, I'm like, this is way too damn short. And they went right into the damn, I'm like, this is the final fight. And then they just, doop, 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 oh, he's gone, we saved the world.
So he was killing people with his mind. But they fought him.
Damn, he was putting the beta choke on him?
Yes. Killed her father. He didn't even have to kill her father. He didn't have no beef with her father. His father tried to say, try to talk some reason in him. He had all this power. He could have just looted it. He just poof, turned his ass, lit him on fire. Boiled him and kept on.
Victor had all of their power.
But he didn't kill them.
Oh yeah, he can.
He can. You don't have to lift a hand, but you let them fight you.
Out of this movie, and here's the thing I will say. I will say that Thing looked a lot better in this movie than he did in the other Fantastic Four movie.
He did.
He did look better.
He should have had some shorts on.
he had his pillows flying all over the place.
Should have had some shorts.
Did he have no drawers on?
He out there like Kool-Aid.
Going straight Silver Surfer son?
Straight Silver Surfer son. Straight.
But he ain't had no Dr. Manhattan.
Thank goodness. Hey, I watched that on the Sci-Fi channel. They had that part blurred out, thank God.
Sci-Fi ain't gonna show big.
And I know Blue Dick anyway. But so, that's what he looked like. He looked like a burn victim who fell into like kryptonite fire. Like the kryptonite jelly juice.
So basically, Fantastic Four is a mashup
of all these other better movies.
Yes.
That you should just rewatch again.
Pretty much.
Instead of watching this one.
To see Fantastic
Four. Hey, look, we were coming out of Resurrection F the other day, and we were walking. These two kids ran past going to Fantastic Four. I was like, don't do it.
They should have tackled him. I just saved your life.
You're never getting that time back.
Oh. Yeah, that's 100 minutes you can't get back.
Oh, so no Fantastic Four.
Just call it Four. There's nothing fantastic about it.
So no Four.
No Four. Look, on a high note, I will say Dragon Ball Z has been extended in theaters to the August 17th. So if you haven't seen it, find a theater and go see it. You won't be disappointed.
You definitely don't want to waste your money on
it. No, or, no, not at all. Because if you're a Dragon Ball Z fan, it was worth it. It was worth it. I've seen it twice. I'm thinking about it a third time.
I think any company, I'm talking 20th Century Fox, Fox Studios,
Sony,
just give back the rights.
There's actually a petition that's going around that people are signing for Fox Studios to release the rights back to Marvel.
Well, see, here's the thing, because they have already approved the sequel to Fantastic Four.
They have.
And it's garbage.
Yes, because it's garbage. Here's the thing. They claim that it's because they have faith in the characters. And they believe they can actually make a decent movie that'll work.
Yeah, of course they do.
We all know that they basically have to make a movie, otherwise they'll lose the rights.
Yeah.
And so that's why they're gonna do another movie. Cause if they don't, they're gonna still do another movie. They're gonna do another remake.
Garbage.
Oh, straight up, son. Straight up. But.
Four, 2 will never get me again.
So. Oh, yeah, they got a petition. I'll sign it.
How many names can I use? I got like 3 names.
Can you use all 3?
Trying to get this thing fast track.
Garbage, man.
I'll use the Cinnamon Crunch Stormtrooper. You can put that on there.
I'm going to start listing all of his 8 names.
I had like 12.
Goodness, man. I went being hopeful. But here's the thing. When you walk into my new coin phrase, Nerdflix.
Yeah.
When you walk into a Nerdflix.
Oh, man.
And there's empty seats.
Yeah.
Just turn around and walk out.
You know how
to. Because we walked in as the show was about to start. So people should have been there.
Past the credit.
Man, that was like 3. The credit. Hey, look, yep. There was like 3 people in there.
Oh, man.
There was like 3 people.
But you already paid for the movie. What you gonna do? Sneak into another one?
We can go back and get your money back.
Yes, you can.
That's one thing about Tinseltown.
This was garbage. We haven't even started yet.
It's starting right now. I can already tell. It's garbage. How do you know? There's 6 people in that theater. And that is, look, it's Theater 20, one of your biggest theaters.
Yeah. How many movies have we gone to see that hasn't been in Theater 1 or 20? Where we've had to go like Theater 10, and you think, oh, this is a big movie. It should be in Theater 20 or Theater 1. No. This one?
It was in a big theater. It should have been in the small one.
You're in 20.
We think
it should have been in the parking lot in somebody's car.
Somebody should have had a tent up, a sheet.
A silk screen laying on the side of the movie theater.
And them dark drapes.
It's like, why can't you see the movie? It's daylight. You don't need to.
Man, it was bad, man. It was bad. It made me want to go watch Man of Steel again. And I don't like that movie.
And I hate to say, I can't find where I saw it at, but I did see something earlier, either today or yesterday, that says they are investigating Josh Trank and his conduct while filming Fantastic Four.
What was
they're thinking about suing his ass.
And here's the thing.
What was his conduct, though?
No one knows. All they said was that he was acting erratic on set. That's why they dismissed him. All that was said was Josh Trank was acting erratic on set.
He was probably saying, this is Bob Smurf!
Well, you know, when you tank and you only make, what,
but here's $12 million? Josh Trank himself said somebody. That the studio was going back behind him and re-editing the film. He said they took out three key action sequences. So it sounds like they screwed themselves, but now they're just going to lay blame at his feet.
But, yeah.
But they took him off the film before they were done. I mean, if you took a director off film right before you were getting ready to throw it in the theater, you could have reshot that movie or done something with it. Hired a new writer and just come up with something else.
Bad. Well, you know, there was more action scene in your Butterfingers commercial.
Really? Yes, there? Yes.
For real? You gonna throw that out there? My Butterfingers commercial? How long ago was that?
I'm saying though, you go back, look at your Butterfingers commercial, you're better than the Fantastic Four right there.
So I should have directed the Fantastic Four.
You should have.
I would have done a pretty good job too. But they say he still, because you know the part of that was that once he finished with this, he's going to go on to Star Wars.
Well, because Star Wars is a Fox, because Fox usually does Star Wars, is a product of Star Wars.
Yeah, he was going to do one of the anthology films.
Yeah, he was going to do Rogue One. Yeah. Once they dismissed him from Fantastic Four, they basically
tossed him out
of the contract for Star Wars and Rogue One.
Is that still a go?
Oh, yeah, Star Wars Rogue One is still a go, but he's not the director.
They can't actually put a director on that.
Yeah, they basically, you can't direct for Star.
Hey, take Empire Strike Back and put two action scenes in it and tell me how good that would be.
Which action
scene? I am not messing with you, young sir. You're not having this discussion because you need to understand something. Empire Strikes Back is the best movie ever made.
I'm just saying.
Movie ever made.
I'm saying. You can pick any two action scenes you want. The entire movie. Plus them two action scenes, and you tell me how good it would be. If it's the best, tell me how good it would be with just two action scenes.
Now, here's the thing I want to know, is because this is the second time Michael B. Jordan has worked with Josh Trank. He worked with him on Chronicle, and the Fantastic Four. I would like to know what he thought about him, because he's worked with the guy before, and then the guy's only directed three movies.
How did he get on a project like this to begin with?
They thought he was a fresh young mind.
Making pancakes.
Maybe that's why they're investigating his erratic behavior.
Man. I'm telling you.
I'm glad I saved my money.
You could have done better. If we had the money to make our own Fantastic Four scene.
Just one scene.
With Play-Doh.
I think we should do that.
It still would have ended up better.
My only question is, who's going to be the original?
Oh, hell no.
She's invisible.
She's already cast.
Exactly.
She hit her down.
All we got to do is ask Lizzie some for some voiceover. That's
one
it.
One down.
That is budgeted at its finest. You never go over budget. Like oh my goodness. But,
it is already better than that first Fantastic Four movie that was made.
The very first one that was never released?
The very first one, yes. The one that was never released.
The one, what was it, 80?
85?
Yes, the one you can find on DVD at any comic convention. Which you can't
find in the store.
Garbage, boy.
Garbage.
I think that movie was better than this one.
Probably.
I think we need to find it and watch it.
I tried watching it once.
You've seen Fantastic Four. Yeah. It's Fantastic Four. I'm sure you can get through.
You've seen four.
You've seen the young Fantastic Four.
Well, as long as the crew is there, anything's tolerable almost.
Even just the
No, I said almost.
You know, right here. Yeah.
You tried to slide
That's
it back.
That's why I said almost.
That's how we got him on Ant-Man. I don't see anything before I see anything.
Damn.
All right. So before we get out of here, fellas, any last words?
Attack on Titan was received very well in Japan. Apparently, because they're going for a second release on it. So I think they're making a part two, or there's a
there's a part two to be released to the movie, so it'll be two parts. Funimation is gonna, I think, looking to release it here on in theaters as well.
No, the live action Attack on Titan?
Yes, the live action.
Didn't they show that on the preview that Resurrection X?
Yes, they did. So, and they're looking at bringing a live action of, not a live action, but they're looking at releasing the new Ghost in the Shell movie to theaters.
Arise,
yeah. Mm-hmm. I think, what was that one you were talking with about Baby Mobile?
The Beast and the Boy.
Yeah, that as well. And a Psychopath movie.
Which I need to check out that series.
It's kind of like, you remember that weird one you had with the powers and the killers? The anime you collected in a while back. I can't remember what it is, but it's kind of like a cross between Ghost in the Shell and... I can't think of the name.
Oh, I probably still have it.
Yeah, you had the series, but it was a Twisted Dark series. Like, Twisted version on
the... Well, the photographer?
Yeah. And yeah,
it was like he would use the different cameras, and he would like he would use something happened with his eyes, and he would like whenever he take a picture, it would be like a bazooka. He blow stuff up, and the different sizes of the cameras is a different explosion.
So this Cowboy Bebop?
No,
pretty much, yeah.
Psychopath is basically a society that has been given that everyone's been hooked up to this this machine called Sybil, and basically it's kind of like Goes in a show where everyone has a cyber brain, but it's where everyone with psychograph can be measured. It can be, and depending on your psychograph, you're either given a job, you're given a certain job, and if it's too violent, if it's too deep, violent, you're basically, tagged as a criminal. And in this, some of the criminals are used as enforcers to go along with inspectors to catch other criminals, because that's who they use. They figure who's better than catching criminals and criminals.
Oh, like a big ass snitch movie.
I think you feel a little upset with Invisible Woman about the many times that she snitched.
Hey, she ain't getting no stitches though. So
I thought Johnny hit her with the flame on.
Yeah, she protected herself.
She put a bubble on.
Put a bubble on.
Yeah. I couldn't get with her with as Invisible Woman. Her nose was way too.
I heard the wig was bad.
I don't know, but look, one scene, she was wet, and it was dark, her hair would turn brown, and then the next scene, it was live, right on it.
Did I fall asleep?
Yeah, you
probably don't remember that. Even saying,
you were probably thinking about leaving, because I sat forward, and I was like, did I see that?
That was an Egyptian Fantastic Four, unrated version. You got one scene, she was wet. Down the way. But if nothing else,
that's all I got.
Straight out of Compton. Oh,
check us out on Tumblr, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, website www.thegreatedition.com and Flipboard. Come back every Friday night. Check us out
from Tuesday Twitch.
Twitch Tuesdays. Maybe even more to come.
Maybe
6-ish to 8-ish.
9-ish.
To when we wrap it up.
Well, ever since Straight Out of Compton, you're getting a little gangster.
Oh, my bad.
Need you to calm down.
My bad.
I need you to do. My bad. But other than that,
crazy. Oh. My bad.
Peace.
Too slow, Straight Out of Compton.
Need to calm you down. Calm your ass down. Okay. Well, I'm wicked. I'm just playing wicked. I'm just playing.
Hold on now. Wicked had to go to the world with it.
Uh-oh. You know what we should do? Should do all juicing dances.
Gotta call them out.
Stop it.
Wow. Gotta call them out.
Stop
juice
it.
And shuffle.
You gotta call them out so somebody know they're real. Back scratch.